विश्याम वाच मां प्रसुत्तां संजीवयत्तिखिल शक्तिधरस्वधाम्ना अन्यांश्च हस्तचरणश्रवणत्वगादीन् प्राणान् नमो भगवते पुरुषाय तुभ्यं गुरुं हि स्वयं सत्यः प्रज्ञाभक्तिविनीतयः भीतिश्चापि कृता नित्यं तं गुरुं प्रणमाम्यहम् सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्। ॐ आप्यायन्त ममाङ्गानि वाक् प्राणश्चक्षुश्रोत्रमथोबलमिन्द्रियाणि च सर्वाणि सर्वं ब्रह्म औपनिषदम् माहं ब्रह्म निराकुर्यां मामा ब्रह्म निराकरोत् अनिराकरणमस्तु अनिराकरणं मे अस्तु। तदात्मनिरते उपनिषत्सु धर्मास्ते मयि सन्तु ते मयि सन्तु। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्ति। यश्चित्तेन्द्रियमारुतेरणकरः नेत्रस्य नेत्रं च तं श्रोत्रश्रोत्रमिमं हृदोऽपि हृदयम् वाचश्च वाचं परम् प्राणप्राणमिहाधिगत्य कुशलाः आत्मानमस्तैषणाः त्यक्त्वेमां तनुमाप्नुवन्ति परमं विष्णोः पदं शाश्वतम्। चक्षुर्नाञ्च दिवप्रभागपि मनः ज्ञाताद्यदन्यत्तथा ज्ञाताद्यन्न गिरोदितं समुदिता वाणी च येन स्वयं बुद्ध्यायन्नमतं च येन दुमता बुद्धिश्रवश्चक्षुषी यज्जानाति न यद्यतो नितिमरुत् तद्ब्रह्मणोपासितम्। वेदाहं बृहदित्यवैति मनसा यो वेदब्रं स तत् नो वेदास्मि न वेदनेति मनुते यो वेद सम्यक् स तत्। विज्ञातं त्वभिजानतां बृहदभिज्ञातं पुनर्जानतां ज्ञातं मे प्रतिबोधमेतदिति तत् मत्वामृतं विन्दते। जानात्येतदिहैव योऽस्ति स सदा ब्रह्मात्मना सर्वतः नो जानाति तु यो विनाशमयते भूयां समज्ञः सना। ज्ञात्वैवं कुशला विचिन्त्य परमं भूतेषु भूतेषु तत् ब्रह्मास्मेकमिति प्रपद्य परिहायाङ्गं भजन्ते मृतम्। यस्यानुग्रहतो विजिज्ञरसुरान् इन्द्रादयो देवताः शक्नोति स्म तृणं न दग्धुमनलः क्षेप्तुं च नैवानिलः। यस्यानुग्रहवर्जनादधिगतं देवैरुमाभाषितात् यक्षाकारधनं च यल्लसति तत् विद्योतनं विद्युतां। So we were looking at the meaning of this verse 11. So this verse 11, as I was mentioning, so paraphrases the entire khanda plus one or two mantras of the next khanda also. Because this vidyotanam vidyutam is a phrase which does not appear in this khanda but appears in the next khanda. So we were looking at the episode in the previous class, and I was mentioning to you that between Devas and Asuras, so there was a yuddha, and Devas won over the yuddha, and they felt extremely proud of their victory, and it crossed the border of Abhimana, and it turned into sort of arrogance, and therefore, so it was decided by the Almighty to teach them a lesson. Okay. So that was the episode. So and we saw that. So initially, Agni was sent to decipher what this huge, vojas, tejas in front of them is. I was actually looking at the commentary of Bhagavatpada. It is very simple, but it has some very instructive phrases and sentences which he inserts in order to build the Akhyayika. So I was just thinking, I will read this Bhashya for you very quickly. So this Bhashya is very simple here. Tegrim abruvan jata veda etadvijanihi. The text itself is very simple. Te means devaha. Abruvan is stated. Whom did they say? Jata veda, addressing the Agni. Etadvijanihi kim etadyakshamiti. So here he says, Bhagavatpada says, te means tadajanantaha, okay, devaha. Then he uses the phrase santarbhayaha. There is a sense of fear which was generated in them. Santarbhayaha, do not know somebody, okay. So then suddenly it appears any new form will generate a sense of fear. So santarbhayaha tadvijnyadasva agnim abruvan agragaminam jatavedasam. So it's a phrase that he uses. Agragaminam jatavedasam. Okay. Sarvajnya kalpam. Every household there used to be agni maintained. So therefore agni, if you conceive in the form of devata, so he knows, he is always there. Whether water is there or not, Agni will be there. So this is how the household used to be maintained. There will be a certain Agni Shala. And from there you draw, and then you once again perform the ritual. So leave it. So this is how it used to be. So Jata Vedaha, and anything that happens in the house, so whether it is good thing, bad thing, so Agni will be used. So therefore, Agni is considered as Jata Vedaha. So whatever that is happening, he knows as a witness. Okay. Therefore, he is using the phrase Sarvajnya Kalpam. Kalpam means Ishadune Kalpapu. Okay. Almost like a Sarvajnya. That is the phrase. Sarvajnya Kalpam Abruvan Uktavantaha. What did they say? Hey Jata Vedaha. Yetat Asmat gocharastham yaksham vijanihi. Vijanihi means visheshato janihi. Go and inquire who he is, what is the purpose of his visit here. Okay. Buddhyasva vijanihi. Tvam naha tejasvi kimedad yakshamiti. Tathastu. fellow said. See, this tathastu is something which you would have heard. See? So when a ritual is performed, so the Brahmins will say, so somebody will say, so may he get all good, tathastu. Tathastu iti tat yaksham abhi adravat abhyadravat. Abhi means keeping in front, he went. Abhyadravat. Tat pratigatavan agnihi tanchagatavantam. See, here he uses the word piprichu. Repeat. Piprichu means prashtumichu. Prashtumichu, piprichu. This Agni was a piprichu. He wanted to ask something. Okay, prashtumicha, piprichha. So this fellow had this desire to ask. But then Bhagavad Pada hears, he says, he could not open his mouth. See, sometimes it happens. So he just go. And then words do not come. So you are either, you are overcome by anxiety, or you are, somehow, I mean, the words do not emerge on various occasions when you meet great people. The mind becomes just blank. Okay? So that is why he is saying, Tancha gatavantam vipurchum tat samipe apragalbhatvat is the phrase. Tat samipe means in the so in front of that, huge effulgence. So he felt that he was almost insignificant. Apragalbhatvat tushnim bhutam tadyaksham abhyavadat agnim prati abhashata. So what did it say? Kositi. Who are you, man? Evam brahmana prishtaha agnihi abravit. He said, Agnirva ahamasmi jataveda va iti. So here Bhagavad Pada says, iti cha namadvayena prasiddham namadvayena prasiddhataya namadvayena prasiddhataya atmanam shlaghayanni. Shlaghayanni. So from the way you reply, I am Agni. You can guess, no? Whether he is humble. Or otherwise. Atmanam shlakayan niti. Evamuktavantam brahma avochat. Tasmin evam prasiddha guna. Evam prasiddha guna namavati. Prasiddha guna namavati. Okay. Prasiddham nama prasiddha. Prasiddha kashchana guna. Kim viryam samarthyamiti. Very, very simple. What is the strength in you? May you know that. Kim virjam samarthyamiti. So abravit. So then Agni says, idam jagat sarvandaheyam bhasmi kuryam yat idam sthavaradi prithivyam iti. Sarvandaheyam vididam prithivyam iti. So then, here Bhagavad Pada adds, prithivyamiti upalakshanartham. Upalakshanartham is just a just a sample. Okay? So it doesn't. So upalakshanartham yadaha antarikshasthamapi rahyate eva agnina tasmai evam abhimanavate. Abhimana. Abhimanavate tasmai evam abhimanavate brahma trinannidathau. Just dropped a blade of grass. Trinannidathau puraha agnehe sthapitavat brahmana. Then he says, Bhagavad Pada adds a long sentence. He says, yetat trinamatram mama agrataha daha. So he says, yetat daheti. Yetat means trinamatra. Yetat trinamatram mama agrataha daha. He further adds, nache dasi dagdhum samarthaha muncha dagdhritva abhimanam sarvatra. You understand? is a very important message in this. That's why I wanted to read this for you. This is a very, very simple, nice commentary. He says, though it is not there in the text, Bhagavad-Pada adds this, nache dasi dagdhum samarthaha muncha dagdhutvabhimanam sarvatra. Ittyuktaha saha trinam upapreyaya trinasamipam gatavan sarvajavena sarvotsaha krutena vegena. With all the might he wanted to point. Gatva tat nashashaka nashakat nashashaka. He was not able to burn that. Okay. Saha jatavedaha trinam dagdhumashaktaha vriditaha. Vriditaha means vrida. Vrida means shame. Vriditaha, ashamed. Okay. Vriditaha, why ashamed? Bhagavad Pada says hataprajnyaha. So that should be the source of shame. Okay. I was unable to, so I was so proud of myself and I made some big statement and hataprajnyaha, I could not keep up the words. Hataprajnyaha vriditaha. So this is, you should know, you should say that I will submit my report this weekend. So if you are not able to do, should be a vrida in you. So this is something which is very important. Vriditaha, nowadays people are become shameless. Pratijna, no, who cares? Okay. Hatha pratijnyaha tatayeva yaksha deva tushnim devan prati nivavrute. Tushnim nivavrate nivrittaha pratikatavan na yetat yaksham mashakam shaktavan aham vijnatum visheshataha yadetad yakshamiti. I could not know. That shame itself made him. So no more questions. Okay, he just returned back. He could not further continue any conversation with him. So the Agni returned him. Then they sent Vayu. Vayu Mabhruvan. Vayo etad vijanihi. Same story. Kim etad yakshamiti. Tatheti. Tadabhya dravat. Tamabhya vadat. Kositi. Vayurvahamasmi. Matarishvava. What is Matarishva? The word Matarishva basically means Antarikshe. Matari. Antarikshe Svayate Gachatiti Matarishva. Okay? The one who moves in space freely. That is how the word is to be understood. Vayurva Ahamasmi Matarishvava Ahamasmiti Tasmin Stvai Kimbir Yamiti Abhidagam Sarvamadadiya. Similarly, he said. Yajidam prasivyamiti tasmai trinan nidathau yetada datsveti adupapreyaya sarvajavena tanna shashaka adatum. He was not able to even lift that blade of grass. Tanna shashaka adatum. See, we should understand this, that this is not an impossibility even in today's thing. It may look like something, if you can think of condensed matter like that, nothing can be done. So most of the matter has only some vacuum, even the densest of matters. So that is why we think of, even today, we understand that when these objects, they sort of condense, so they become terribly, terribly dense, and nothing can be done. तन्न शशाकादातुं स तत एव निववृते नैतदशकं विज्ञातुं यदेतद्यक्षमिति. नाउ द चांस इज फॉर इंद्रा नाउ. ओके, सो व्हाट डज इंद्रा डू? सो दे अप्रोच इंद्रा नाउ. इंद्रा अथेन्द्रम अब्रुवन. इफ यू लुक एट the second half of the verse, shaknoti sma trinam nadaktu manalaha kshetuncha naiva nilaha. So analaha is fire, anilaha is wayu. How does the word come about?
Alam.
So you can say navidyate alam buddhi yasya saha. Okay, so the fire does not have alam buddhi. Whatever you keep offering, it will keep consuming. So it will not say enough. Navidyate alam buddhi yasya saha analaha. Okay, anilaha. Aniti, aniti. We are familiar with the word praniti. Understand? Aniti anena. See? So the one who enables us to breathe in, breathe out. Okay. Aniti, praniti. The one who lives, makes you live, rather. Okay? Anityaneneti. There is a ilach pratyaya. Anila. Okay. And this anila was not able to move. Shikshiptum cha naiva nilaha. And the reason for being unable to is stated by Ramaraya in the third quarter. Yasya anugraha varjanat. Anugraha varjanat means the blessings, okay, the grace. So the grace of that was withdrawn. The grace to do that was withdrawn, and once it is withdrawn, so they were unable to perform what they felt that they excel in. Yasya anugraha varjanat. Then they sent Indra, so that he does not say explicitly, but then he sort of paraphrases. Devairuma bhashitat yakshahakaradharam. The story here is, after that they send Indra. Okay. Athendram abruvan. That is how the Upanishad goes. Upanishad says, Athendram abruvan. So all of them, they requested. See, so these two people who are great, so they have not been able to find out. Why don't you yourself go? Athendram abruvan maghavan. एतद्विजानीहि किमेतद्यक्षमिति. मघवन् इज ए सॉर्ट ऑफ एडजेक्टिव टू इंद्र. इंद्र ब्रुवन् रादर एन एड्रेसिंग वर्ड इज यूज्ड. इट इज लाइक महाराजा. सो यू डोंट कॉल हिम बाय नेम, राइट? सो यू डोंट कॉल द पीपल बाय नेम. मघवन् एतद्विजानीहि मघवन्. So it basically comes from Mahyate Pujyate. It comes that Maghava, Maghavanu, Maghavanaha. That is how the word goes. Athendram abruvan maghavan etad vijanihi kimetad yakshamiti tatheti tadabhyadravat tasmatirodhate. So as Indra was approaching close to that, it disappeared. Tasmat tirodathe. Tirodathe means it completely disappeared. Tirodathe. Then the story goes. Tasmat tirodathe sadasmin neva akashe striyama jagama bahushobhamanam umam haimavatim tam ho vacha kimetadyakshamiti. So there ends the khanda. Okay. So the third khanda ends with this. So what does it say? He disappeared. But then Indra did not return back. So he just stood there. Taking some compassionate view on Indra. So it reappeared in a different form. So that is what is stated in the Upanishad. Umam haimavatim tasminneva akashe. In the same place, after a while, some feminine form came. Umam haimavatim. So that is how the Upanishad describes. Tasminneva akashe. In the same space. Striyam ajagama bahushobhavanam umam haimavati. Tam hovacha. So then to that entity, Indra asked, kime tadyakshamiti. So what really happened? What is that entity? So then it goes. So I will very quickly read commentary here. It's very, very simple again. अथ इंद्रमब्रुवन् मघवन् एतद्विजानीहि इति पूर्ववत् इंद्रः परमेश्वरः मघवा बलवत्वात् तथेति तदभ्यद्रवत् तस्मात् इंद्रात् आत्मसमीपं गतात् तद्ब्रह्म तिरोदधे मोमेंट दिस फेलो ओके इंद्रस्य इंद्रत्वाभिमानः अतितराम् निराकर्तव्यः. This is what is very interesting. So this is Bhagavad Pada's addition here in his commentary. Why did it disappear when Indra came? इंद्रस्य इंद्रत्वाभिमानः अतितराम् निराकर्तव्यः. So there is some important message for us to learn from this point. See, after all, one needs to understand, even these people, Agni, Vayu, etc., they had some abhimana and that abhimana was trashed. So in the case of Indra, so as the commentary of Bhagavad Pada indicates, so he was their leader. So the leader, Devadhipati, is supposed to train people to think the right way. So his abhimana is far more superior to the abhimana of these fellows. Understand? So the leader should show the way. There is a phrase in Sanskrit which I heard from my father, and he said once that Paramacharya, I don't know, I have to just trace, suddenly I recalled that the Kanchi Paramacharya, Chandrasekharendra Saraswati, once apparently in some dialogue with my father, I mean just casually speaking to him. So he used to call my father Krishnamurti. Krishnamurti. See, people call me Jagadguru. People call me Jagadguru. Many a times I feel that this adjective does not really fit in. So I feel like even saying that don't describe me as Jagat Guru. So why is he saying all this? My father was wondering. Then he said, Jagat Guru means Guru of all people here in the Jagat. I am really scared. Why? He quotes some phrase. Shishya Papam Gurum Brajet. Shishya Papam गुरुं व्रजेत, दिस इज व्हाट स्मृतिस आर सेइंग. Forget about all people in the world. So our own people in the matha. So they are my own shishyas. And if this smriti is to be taken as it is, so then, so I will be incurring all the sins. So I feel like not being described as Jagat Guru. Okay. So having said that, anyway, I cannot stop so people using this. So I decided to interpret this term in a different way for myself. So instead of saying that this Shabda is Shashti Tatpurusha, Jagataha Guruhu, I take it as Karmadharaya. Oh, sorry, Bahuvrihi. Bahuvrihi. I take it as a Bahuvrihi. So Bahuvrihi means Jagat Guruhu Yasya Saha. So he says that I consider the entire Jagat as my Guru. Okay, so in which case I will be saved from this Papa. So I mean, he just said this. Why am I reminded? So I am reminded because this fellow was the leader. So his abhimana was far more, and therefore he had to be taught more serious lesson. So then it disappeared. That is what Bhagavad Pada here says. Indrasya indratva abhimanaha atitaram nirakartavyaha. So the leader is taught the lesson. Atitaram nirakartavyaha. In fact, I am also reminded of this abhimana. Abhimana is atimanaha, abhimanaha, both are used. Atimanaha, abhimanaha, basically they mean that I am to be respected by everybody. Aham sarvaihi pujaniyaha. Atishayena pujaniyaha. Na atimanaha. Manaha is Atishayena Pujaniya. I have to be respected. So this is a big problem. I have to be respected means my words have to be respected. So they have to listen. At least give a patient hearing. So if these are not done, there is a huge problem. Atimanaha. So this Abhimana. So this has to be knocked off. In fact, there is a nice verse. So contrast this with what Kalidasa describes in the Raghu Vamsha. He says, Prajanam Vinayadhanatu. Prajanam vinayadhanat rakshanat bharanadapi sapita pitarastasam kevalam janmahetavah. It's a beautiful description. The first thing that has to be inculcated by parents is humility. And as a leader, as a king, he has to see to it that it happens. It happens not by words, it happens by action. Prajanam vinayadhanat. That is the description. And in fact, the Paramacharya was an exceptional example of that. Okay, you have seen Vinayadhanat. Vinayadhanat. Here this Abhimana should be knocked off. See, Indrasya Indratva Abhimanaha, particularly when you are head. Abhimanaha. That is why we have even this Bhagavad Pada Shatpadi Stotra commencing with Avinayam Apanaya Vishnu. That is the first prarthana. Avinayam Apanaya Vishnu Damaya Manaha, and so on it goes. Shamaya Vishaya Mrigat Krishna Indrasya Indratva Abhimanaha Atitaram Nirakartavyaha Ityataha Samvadamatramabhi Nadat Brahmendraya. Samvadamatramapi Nadat. इंद्राय ओके ब्रह्म इंद्राय ब्रह्मेन्द्राय संवाद नादात ब्रह्म इंद्राय ब्रह्मा डिड नॉट इवन टॉक टू दिस फेलो ओके तद्यक्षम यस्मिन् आकाशे आकाश प्रदेशे आत्मानं दर्शयित्वा तिरोभूतम् इट वेरेवर इट डिसअपीयर्ड ब्रह्मणः तिरोधान काले यस्मिन् आकाशे आसीत् वेरेवर इट वाज देयर सः इन्द्रः तस्मिन्नेव आकाशे तस्थौ सो दिस फेलो डिड नॉट इमीडिएटली रिटर्न ओके इट हैज गॉन सो लेट अस गो बैक समहाउ दिस फेलो फेल्ट What is it? Did not even talk to me. So he was maybe internally, so Indra transformed. So what is this? This is such a terrible shame for me. Did not even give audience to me. Okay. Sometimes this happens. So this is one of the ways to teach people. So if they come, you don't talk. Or you just get away from the seat and go. So that will be far more humiliation, right? So he says, see, that is why Bhagavad Pada here says, see, Saha Indraha Tasmin Neva Akashe Tasthau Kim Pradyakshamiti Dhyayan Na Niva Vrte Agnya Divat okay. So he did not simply return Agnya Divat. So maybe he took a pledge that till I am seeing, I am not going. So then you may also return back, no? If that fellow does not. So this happens, right? When you commit something, so you don't talk. So the child starts crying. Then after some time, okay, so let us talk. Okay? So this I have seen. Or rather, I have also been a witness of this. So parents sometimes do this. Okay? So this is Nivavrate Agnya Divat. अज्ञाधिपति ही डिड नॉट गो बैक तस्य इंद्रस्य यक्षे भक्तिं बुद्ध्वा हैविंग अंडरस्टूड ओके द डीप सेंस ऑफ डिवोशन एंड सो द काइंड ऑफ फीलिंग ऑफ इंद्र ओके सो इट इज रिपेंटेंस सो दिस डिसाइडेड टू अपीयर इन अ डिफरेंट फॉर्म तस्य इंद्रस्य यक्षे भक्तिं बुद्ध्वा सो नाउ भगवत्पाद सेज विद्या उमा रूपिणी प्रादुर्भूत स्त्री रूपा विद्या उमा रूपिणी प्रादुर्भूत ऑल दैट वी हैव इन द मंत्र ये स्त्रियमा जगामा बहुशोभमानां उमां हैमवती Now, Bhagavad-pada says vidyam. So, in our culture, we have an embodiment for vidya. We have an embodiment for Lakshmi. So, we have vidya itself took this form. So, vidya is a sthrilinga shabda. So, this vidya itself took the form okay, of something which is so beautiful, which appearing to the eyes. Bahushobhamanam. So it just appeared, Vidya Uma Rupini Pradurabhut Stri Rupa Saha Indraha Tam Umam Bahushobhamanam. So here Bhagavad Pada adds an interesting sentence. Why does the Shruti say Bahushobhamanam? Is it describing the physical beauty? Or could there be something which is far more to be understood from that phrase? So therefore, he brings in this idea, Sarvesham hi shobhamanam shobhanatama vidya. This is a very interesting usage. Sarvesham hi shobhamanam shobhanatama vidya. There is nothing which is equal to this. In fact, beautiful slokas. Vidyanama narasya rupamadhikam. Vidyanama narasya rupamadhikam prachanna guptam dhanam. Right? More importantly, I think one more verse is there. निरुक्तनो केयूराणि न भूषयन्ति पुरुषं हारा न चन्द्रोज्ज्वला न स्नानं न विलेपनं न कुसुमं नालंकृता मूर्धजाः वाण्येका समलंकरोति पुरुषं या संस्कृता धार्यते क्षीयन्ते किल भूषणानि सततं वग्भूषणं भूषणं. A beautiful thing. See, when you learn such things, when you are in the impressionable age, you understand the value of vidya. See, otherwise, I mean, you will value something else in life. And you don't even know how to respect scholars. See? So this says, Keyurani Nabhushayanti Purusham. These things do not adorn, which people think as ornaments. Keyurani Nabhushayanti Purusham. Hara na chandrojvala. I am wearing a beautiful necklace. I can draw the attention of everybody. Hara na chandrojvala nasnahanam na vilepanam. So you apply some scents, the fragrance of various oils. Na vilepanam na kusumam na alankrita murthajaha. Murthaja means murthajaha. Murthni jayante. No, not there. Here. Nalankrita murthajaha. See, nowadays, see, I am told, sometimes my mother feels very bad. Okay? For having gone to some reception. Okay? Enna koothu thangala. Talaviri kutu is one thing, is a phrase. And they put various kinds of things. Okay? And you cannot even see the figure. See, sometimes I have seen one funny thing. In flights, some people just... So, forehead will not be visible. So, they try to hang something down. Okay? Some kind of a thing. Anyway, so he says, Nalankrita murthajaha. So, these things do not add anything to you. Okay. Then he says, Vanyeka samalankaroti purusham. It is vidya alone, yeka samalankaroti purusham. Beautifully adorns the person. And further it is said, ya samskrita dharyate. That is again a very, very important phrase. See, mere vidya does not help. That should be a samskrita vidya. So samskrita means which has been able to imbibe virtues in you. Okay? Otherwise, it can just be. That's why I think there is a hint. There is another nice verse which says, okay. Durjanaf parihartavyaha vidyaya lankritopi san. Manina bhushita sarpaha kimasau na bhayankaraha. This is very important thing. So if that cannot inculcate virtues in you, it is actually no vidya. So therefore it is said, durjanaha. See, you are not endowed with virtues. Pariharthavyaha, avoid it. Vidyalankritopi sannu. Even if he possesses some skills, so he should be ignored. So then it says, Manina bhushita sarpaha kimasauna bhayankaraha. So he is like a sarpa. I mean, it was said there by, recently it was told by some Swamiji. Anyway, so this in connection with someone, some pandita. So then he immediately quoted this verse and then said, no, see, not acceptable. See, what by mere vidya? So he just quoted this. So see, ya samskrita dharyate. Finally it says, kshiyante khila bhushanani satatam vagbhushanam bhushanam. So all these ornaments will just wither away. They cannot adorn you. Vagbhushanam bhushanam. So this alone. That is why here Bhagavad Pada says, see, this adds, see, sarvesham hi shobhamananam. Sarvesham hi shobhamananam. Shobhanatama vidya. It's a very beautiful place. तदा बहुशोभमाना बहुशोभमानेति विशेषणम् उपपन्नम् भवति देन ओनली दिस एडजेक्टिव रियली फिट्स विद्यारूपिणी उमा तदा बहुशोभमानेति विशेषणम् उपपन्नम् भवति हैमवती हेमकृता भरणवती मिव अनदर वे ऑफ से हेमकृत आभरणवती बहुशोभमाना एट अ लोअर लेवल सो दिस कैन आल्सो बी टेकन आई मीन इफ यू वांट टू थिंक ऑफ दैट वे अथवा ही सेज उमैव हिमवतः दुहिता हैमवती another way of saying okay so himavan haimavati means parvati the famous goddess parvati haimavati nityameva sarvajnena ishvarena sahavartate iti jnatum samartheti kritva tam upajagama indraha tam umam kilavu vacha he just asked what does he ask kimetat darshayitva tirobhutam yakshamiti presented itself and when he came he disappeared. What is it? Kimetat darshayitva gatamiti. Now, if you look at the third quarter of this verse, yasya anugraha varjanat adhigatam devair umabhashitat. Adhigatam means it is known. Known what is known. So the reply of this Uma is actually carried to the next khanda. Brahmeti ho vacha Brahmano va etad vijaye mahi yathamiti tato haiva vidanchakara brahmeti. So the answer is okay, the first mantra of the next khanda, fourth khanda. So it replied, Uma said, Brahmeti ho vacha. So it is that Brahman itself which came in the form of Yaksha. Brahmeti ho vacha. Then it also adds one more sentence, okay, that form, okay, adds one more sentence. Brahmano va etad vijaye mahi yathamiti. So you actually felt that you were solely responsible for the victory, okay, that you had. So that is not correct. So someone else's power has been utilized by you in this form, and therefore you should understand that it was the grace of that entity which made you do this. And not your own might. Brahmano va etad vijaye mahi yathamiti tato haiva vidanchakara brahmeti. Then this fellow Indra understood. That is what is stated in the fourth quarter of this verse. Devairuma bhashitat. So all of them they understood. So Indra came back with this message. Okay. So that is essentially to teach us this lesson that this actually happened. Yakshakara dharam cha yallasati tat vidyotanam vidyutam. In fact, the last phrase is Vidyutam Vidyotanam means. So Vidyut is something which really strikes in the sky. Okay, the lightning. So the lightning, which is essentially huge release of energy, which is witnessed by us in the sky, can make you blind if you see. So that release of energy, so is essentially because of this being. So the energy in every being is being supplied by a certain entity, and you should not really think that you have done something. Okay, this abhimana should be aham nimitta matra. Okay, that way, भगवान ऑल्सो से निमित्त मात्रम भव सव्यसाचिम मे यू कंसिडर युअर सेल्फ एज ए मियर निमित्त सो दिस मे लुक एज इफ आई मीन दे आर जस्ट सेइंग समथिंग बट इट हैज enormous sense. So in trying to lead the life in the right way, okay, makes a lot of sense to appreciate its beauty. Why they say this? So now if you look at this fourth quartal, yallasati tat vidyotanam vidyutam तत् विद्योतनं विद्युतां तत् लसति. In fact, the entire Bhagavad Gita, 10th chapter, the entire 10th chapter, it is only trying to convey this in various ways. यद्यद् विभूतिमत्सत्त्वं श्रीमदुर्जितमेव तत्तदेव अवगच्छत्वं मम तेजोंश संभवम्. So that is what we need to understand. यद्यद् विभूतिमत्सत्त्वं Wherever you see the glory, tatta deva vagacchatum mate yumsha sambhavam. There is a beautiful philosophy behind this. Now it says, tad vidyotanam vidyutam. So let us very quickly read this. So here it is said, yaduktam, if you take the commentary, yaduktam brahmanaha astitu. अधिकमत् रविमरुत् वह्नादिचेष्टा दधदिति तदेव स्फुटयति. स्फुटयति मीन्स् हि एलाबरेट्स् ऑन दैट. इन्द्रादयो देवताः यस्य अनुग्रहतः एव असुरान् विजिज्ञुः जितवन्तः. असुरान् विजिज्ञुः. So you know the meaning of asura. Asura, one can do the vigraha in many ways. One way is asun rati. Asun rati iti asura. See, asuhu means pranaha. See, in Tamil, we have a phrase. Pranana vangade. Means... Anyone who keeps troubling you. So sometimes the elderly people say, Prana vangada ananda poyen. Means you go, okay, you go away from me, don't take my life away from me. So this is what it is. So this asun rati means this asura swabhava. That is what essentially we have to understand. This asura swabhava, when it is exhibited, the life is gone. You cannot live a happy life. Simple. Okay. So it is a metaphorical usage. It's not that he is making you stop breathing. So this is a metaphorical usage. So this asun rati, see ra, see da adana yoku. It is used in both sense. Rati. Okay. Asun rati ki asuraha. The other way is asu. See asyate kshipyate. This is another way of seeing. Asyate kshipyate. What is being thrown off? See, these qualities, if they are there, see, certain qualities, they knock off all the daivi qualities. So those who possess those qualities, they are actually called asuras. Okay? The qualities which take the life in others, and of course, life in themselves also. Okay? So this is what is basically referred by these asura. That is why we have no Bhagavad Gita. They list no Daivi Sampat, Asuri Sampat. Okay. Asuri Sampat is Dambho Darpo Bhimanascha Krodhav Parushyamevacha Ajnanam Chabhijatasya Partha Sampada Masuri. Okay. Dambha, so we saw no. That is why this asura. So Bhagavad Pada in his commentary was saying no. In the previous class I read, may these people do not turn into asuras. So in order to save them, this has to be taught to them. So dambhaha, dambho darpaha. Dambhaha means धर्मध्वजित्व दैट इज हाउ भगवत्पादा राइट्स धर्मध्वजित्व दंभ धर्मध्वजी मीन्स ही परफॉर्म समथिंग एंड देन ही ट्राइज टू फ्लैग इट अप सो परफॉर्मिंग सम स्मॉल थिंग ओके सो आई हैव अचीव्ड दिस आई हैव अचीव्ड धर्मध्वजित्व सो दंभ दर्पः दर्पः actually can arise by three means. This is arrogance. Madaha essentially. So darpaha is dambaha, darpaha. Darpaha is madaha. Mada can actually arise by three means. So primarily, so it has been nicely listed. Nicely listed in Vidyaniti. Vidya mado dhana madaha. Repeat. विद्या मदो धनमदः तृतीयाभिजने मदः तृतीयोभिजने मदः मदायेते वलिप्तानां मदायेते वलिप्तानां येतयेव सतां दमाः This is actually a very beautiful verse, really beautiful. So here that is what we see. Vidyamadaha, dhanamadaha, tritiyaha, abhijane madaha. So the printed version I saw, abhijano madaha. So that is not quite correct. So, abhijana madaha, if you make it as a compound, it is okay. But if you make a compound, the verse will be gone. The metrical form will be gone. So, therefore, we should just say as abhijane madaha. See, abhijane madaha means saptami, nimitta saptami. Abhijane nimitte yo madaha, abhijana madaha. So, that is how we have to understand that phrase. So, vidya madaha is... The arrogance that is born out of the vidya. Dhanamadaha, a variety of wealth, it can be, it includes all power, etc., etc. That is another madha. And abhijane madaha means that you are high born. If you are the son of a king, son of a minister. See, nowadays some people behave no? unruly way just because he is son of MLA. Nonsense. So, this is what happens. So, atadiya abhijane madaha. Then, madayete avaliptana. See, for fools, these things can be source of arrogance. Whereas for wise people, they themselves are source of humility. Madayete avaliptana. Yete eva satam damaha. So, damaha. So that is what he says. Yataye vasatam damaha. So the asuras, if your attitude is asuric attitude, then they will breed arrogance. If it is a daivik attitude, daivi sampat, we will bring it, the same thing will bring it. So here you see, so that is why this asurane vijigyuhu jitavantaha. So you may recall that vijigyuhu is a little problematic usage, okay, as far as I could see. In the last class I mentioned in detail. Jitavantaha. Yasya anugraha varjanat analaha trinamabhidagdhun na shaknotisma na shakat. So yasya anugraha varjanat. So the ability to think is taken away. Yasya anugraha varjanat. अनलः तृणमपि दग्धुं न शक्नोति स्म अशकत् अनिलश्च तृणमपि क्षेत्तुं नैव शक्नोति स्म यक्षाकारधरञ्च यत् एंड द वन विच एक्चुअली केम इन द फॉर्म ऑफ यक्षा यक्षाकारं धरञ्च तत् यत् देवैः इन्द्रादिभिः उमाभाषितात् Parvati Vakyat. So why is he saying So because we have the phrase Haimavati. Okay? So Himavataha Apatyam Stri Haimavati. That is how it goes. Okay? So Parvati Vakyat Adhigatam Nyatamasi. Vidyutamapi Vidyotanam. Vidyutamapi Vidyotanam. For all the sources that are glowing, the energy behind that glow is provided by Vidyotanam Vidyutam Bhasanam Tat Brahma Lasati. Tasmat Agnyadinam Dahadi Samarthya Pradam Brahma Nasti. Okay, I think we'll stop here. Om Sarve Pisukhinah Santu, Sarve Santu Niramayaha, Sarve Bhadrani Pashyantu, Ma Kashchit Dukha Bhaktave. Om.